Flatside has made a fool of himself again in his latest debate with FTFE. I'll deal with only one topic here: convergence. Flatside seems to think that convergence can explain sunsets. He demonstrated with a light and a couple of buckets in a spray paint booth. He shows that when you move the light further away, after a certain distance the light disappears behind the buckets, or, as he suggests, seems to disappear, caused by convergence. Everyone who knows the very first thing about perspective knows that parallel lines seem to converge in the distance, but lines above your eye height never cross in order to end below your eye height. Flatside thinks that he has shown that they do. However, he used the old trick all flurfers use when demonstrating this non-existent phenomenon. They just put their camera below the flat plane they create by either using a table or, in this case, a couple of buckets in a row. Let's repeat the moment he shows that the light still is there. He moves the camera up and there it is, the light. But let's look a little closer. In this snapshot, the light starts to come into view, but when it isn't, the camera is lower than the buckets. This can be clearly seen later on when he shows that the light that is supposed to be above the buckets is at the height of the bottom of the grate against the back wall, indicating that the buckets are of that same height or less. At the point where he shows the light disappearing, you can clearly see the top of the bucket above the bottom of the grate at the back wall. Evidence that the camera must be below the level of the buckets. So, Flatside is cheating in order to make his point. In my video Flat Earth Nonsense 16, Funny Experiments Not Proving Earth is Flat, I demonstrated that with the sun at a height of 4800 kilometers or 3000 miles over a distance of 45,000 kilometers, the sun never sets. I also showed an animation of the sun along its trajectory, according to so many flurfers, and its height above the horizon. And again, no sunset. FTFE shows his model, but it opens to the critique of Flatside that you cannot see the horizon, so you cannot see the infamous convergence. I therefore made a new model. The sun is represented here at a height of 1000 kilometers and at a distance of respectively 1000 kilometers and from then on at an interval of 5000 kilometers, the greatest distance being 81,000 kilometers. No sunset. Flatside also complained that FTFE didn't take refraction into account. So I took Walter Bislin's Earth Curve Calculator, set it at flat Earth, put in standard refraction and, again, got a height of 1000 meters at a distance of 1000 meters and from there on at an interval of 5000 meters up to a distance of 81,000 meters. And once again, no sunset. I don't care that flurfers believe in a world that doesn't exist. However, when a flurfer has to resort to flat out lying and deceitfully manipulating his so-called proofs, then they overstep the boundaries. But as MC Toon said,
you gotta lie to flurf.